amazing things for our community too when it comes to children living with autism. Fred Bello joins us now to tell us a little bit about what he's doing besides making a lot of pizza and good Italian food during the pandemic. Good morning.
Good morning, Amy. First of all, thank you for having me on and not hating me for my Lions takes, my Detroit Lions takes on Twitter. So
I really enjoy it. Yes, we all have lived with this for a long time. Yeah. Also, for a long time, you have been in the Melvindale community making great food. Tell us a little bit about your restaurant and how things have changed for you during the pandemic.
Well, you know, for me, I'm a very small mom-and-pop place. I don't advertise. People know me. I know them, which I really love and thrive on, knowing my customers. I'm in Ford Country, so where I'm at is a lot of people from around the state, even Ohio, Indiana, come down this way to work because of Ford, Marathon, all these great places around here, and people end up going back home. So at lunchtime, I do a really good lunch. I sell a lot of New York slices, and people know me for my goulash. That's my main dish, and they come in. Now, the last 7-8 months, I don't see them as much. Now, they come in, they trickle in, and they're getting carry out. So it's a great thing, and I'm just happy to see their faces.
Oh, that's wonderful. You get to still interact with your customers. One thing you've also continued to do is fight to support those living with autism. Tell us a little bit about your foundation and how that got started.
Well, Freddy the Pizza Man Foundation started in 2016. Many know my story. My son was diagnosed with autism. I didn't know much about it. I learned so much from my wife. I learned so much from reading and just researching. I wanted to help equip sensory rooms in the state of Michigan. I realized there was a big need in schools. Teachers were reaching out and saying, hey, we need help with sensory rooms. So the foundation started raising money in 2016. And 2020, I did my last two sensory rooms were in March, ironically, 2 days before the pandemic started. One in Wyandotte, one in Troy. That means 17 schools the foundation has worked with, and we've bought $32,000 worth of sensory equipment in the last 8 months. So I think
that is really incredible, and you should be proud of that. But what I'm really just joyful over is hearing that the new thing that you're doing for kids who can't be in school right now. Just an incredible effort there.
Well, you know, the last 8 months, I have 7 schools on the list. I can't get into the schools because they're either closed or we can't come in there. So it's been driving me crazy not to get in and work with these schools because they've written me letters and I want to buy their equipment for them. And I kind of got this, like, writer's block. So I guess when you write a book and you just can't write another page. I've been wanting to do something, and someone reached out to me Friday, a teacher that I've worked with before, said, listen, I have a student that's struggling at home, and is there any way you can help? Light bulb went right off in my head. I said, wait a second, I know exactly what I can do. I can reach out. I went on my Facebook, and I said, my wife and I are going to put out $3,000 from the foundation, and we're going to buy sensory equipment for the kids at home to help the parents, because we're struggling at home, too, with online schooling. The kids are bouncing all over the walls. When you have a kid with special needs, it's just much harder to control them, and that's what a sensory room is all about. So when I went on Facebook Friday, within 2 hours, I had 300 responses.
Wow.
Yeah, 300. So we ended up going up to $4,000, and I was telling you before the meeting started, the last 2 days I spent 2 days on Amazon inputting every address and every parent's name and sending them a piece of equipment that they chose. And those are in the mail now, so hopefully within the next 10 days they'll get that.
Freddie, that is incredible. Such a great thing you're doing for kids and families living with autism. And hopefully I can get you to deliver me a slice of pizza one of these days. I know you don't deliver, but maybe you can make an exception.